What up, citizens, and welcome back to another fantastic day in La La Land. Today is a little bit more of a serious conversation, so citizens, embrace yourself, okay? Sorry, not sorry. Today is Veterans Day, as you guys know, and to a lot of people, that means a lot of different things. The reality is very simple. Today, I observed a lot of people essentially just frolicking along, school, work, whatever the case may be. And the whole point of today is to observe the sacrifice that veterans have made in their contribution to keeping this country safe and so on and so forth. There's a lot of people that have sacrificed so much in America and have given so much, including their lives, you know, family, friends, communities, everything. And I don't believe that we technically honor that the way that we should be honoring that. With that being said, it's very, 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 very important to realize in big major cities like Los Angeles and like New York and like San Francisco and Chicago, it doesn't even have to be big major cities. It could be anything. So many veterans that suffer from so many disorders, like, you know, psychological disorders like PTSD, or amputees that have physical disorders from their time in their service here in the American Army. With that being said, unfortunately, a lot of these people come back to the States after this huge sacrifice and are left to be in positions that you see a lot of them in certain cities like LA and New York. For an example, panhandlers. Every single person that I've seen today, every single person was a Army veteran. I drove past a man in full Army fatigues today, panhandling, asking people for cash. The man had one leg and, you know, was homeless for 3 years. Here's the problem that I have with this, guys. Having a day to say, listen, veterans, you know, you guys did amazing, it's a fantastic sacrifice, you know, fighting for your country, being patriotic, all that's cool, all that's fine and dandy, I get it. But when people truly do sacrifice and they lose so much in life, I think it's important for the community and the country to essentially give back to these people and make sure that these people are in positions when they get back from war, that they have jobs, they have health care, they have benefits. You know, once again, these people have gave the ultimate sacrifice. So with that being said, our streets should not be filled with people that are homeless, that are veterans. By no stretch of the imagination should our streets be filled with homeless veterans. And that's a huge problem. So many people have a problem with certain things going on in the world, and they don't like where people stand politically. I think everybody is united at a certain front when it comes to American veterans and what we think about the veterans and what we should do for the veterans, so on and so forth. I believe that the veterans, unfortunately, in, you know, the battle of Republican, Democratic, get lost in the mix because, you know, once again, both parties look at these people very admirable, but do so little to truly help and contribute to their cause. I'm not saying that's for everybody, but I'm saying in the city of LA, if I had to say, if I met 10 people that were homeless, maybe 6 or 7 of them were veterans. You know, either if it was in the Army, the Air Force, the Navy, Marines, whatever the case may be. So with that being said, guys, I think this Veterans Day, take time out, truly honor somebody that is a veteran. For myself, it's family. I come from a long line of people that served in the military. But with that being said, you know, if you see somebody on the streets that's a veteran, you know, help them out, talk to them. Have a conversation with them. Let them know that they're human, you know, and that things that they go through, you know, somebody's here for them. If it's not the government, if it's not the community, somebody's here for them. So with that being said, guys, we're doing the Veterans Day Challenge. You guys are getting this late, I apologize. But you know what, Veterans Day shouldn't be.
Veterans Day's tomorrow.
Yeah, so you guys are getting this on time because we're gonna load this tomorrow. And we're not gonna put this up today, we'll load this tomorrow. And with that being said, you know, I think it's very, very, very important for you guys to challenge yourself. Talk to veterans, pull over the car, have conversations with people, hear their stories, and really try to figure out what you can do to help people. You know, if you really are patriotic and everybody stands behind this, you know, we're patriots and we're this and we're that. If you really are, and you truly are, for the people that have sacrificed the most, stand behind it. Stand behind it, citizens. That's the word today, all right? So the challenge is get out there. Don't just get drunk and barbecue in your backyards with your friends. Truly, truly, truly honor and respect Veterans Day. Isn't that right, my love?
Yes, but don't just like, be careful who you get out of the car to talk to, because it might be a murderer.
With that being said, guys, and I apologize if that unsensitive comment came at a terrible time Veronica just made right now.
You have to be careful.
I understand.
Stranger danger.
Stranger danger, of course. Of course. You do have to be careful, no matter who you talk to.
There's murderers.
So anyways, guys, with that being said, much love. We will be back tomorrow with our regular, fantastic, fun daily services. Anyways, with that being said, guys, turn those notifications on.
How many times did Dustin say, with that being said, guys?
You know the funny thing about that is, and once Jeez. Again, Veronica could throw a brother off topic harder than anybody else in the world can, but
with that being said,
my boy, that guy Diaz, said that I say fun fact a lot.
And with that being said, guys.
So with that being said, for that guy Diaz, fun fact, you are right. Anyways, guys, much love. And until tomorrow, what are they gonna do?
Live life beautifully with no regrets.
Hey. No, no, no.